Hello, my name is Thales Ancortin and I will present very briefly how the kNN algorithm works. kNN means nearest neighbors. It's a very simple algorithm, and given n training vectors, suppose we have all these A and O letters as training vectors in this b-dimensional feature space, the kNN algorithm identifies the k nearest neighbors of C. C is another feature vector that we want to estimate its class. But in this case, it identifies the nearest neighbors regardless of labels. So suppose this example. We have k equal to 3, and we have the classes A and O. And the aim of the algorithm is to find a class for C. If k is equal to 3, we have to find the 3 nearest neighbors of C. So we can see that in this case, the 3 nearest neighbors of C are these 3 elements here. We have 1 nearest neighbor of the class A, and we have 2 elements of the class O, which are near to C. So we have 2 votes for O and 1 vote for A. In this case, the class of the element C is going to be O. This is very simple how the algorithm K nearest neighbor works. Now, this is a special case of kNN algorithm, is that when k equal to 1, so we must try to find the nearest neighbor of the element will define the class. And to represent this in a feature space, each training vector will define a region in this feature space here. And a property that we have is that each region is defined by this equation. We have a distance between each element x and xi has to be smaller than the same distance for each other element. In this case, we will define a Voronoi partition of the space, which can be defined, for example, this element C and this element E, B, and A will define these regions, very specific regions. This is a property of the kNN algorithm when k is equal to 1. We define regions 1, 2, 3, and 4 based on the nearest neighbor rule. Each element that is inside this area will be classified as A. As well, each element inside this area will be classified as C. And the same for the region 2 and region 3 for classes E and B as well. Now I have just some remarks about the kNN. We have to choose an odd value of k if you have a two-class problem. This happens because when we have a two-class and if we set k equal to 2, for example, we can have a tie. What will be the class, the majority class inside the nearest neighbor? So we have always to set odd values for a two-class problem. And also the value of k must not be a multiple of the number of classes. It's also to avoid ties. And we have to remember that the main drawback of this algorithm is the complexity in searching the nearest neighbors for each sample. The complexity is a problem because we have lots of elements. In the case of a big data set, we will have lots of elements and we have to search the distance between each element to the element that we want to classify. So for a large data set, this can be a problem. Anyhow, this kNN algorithm produces good results. So this is the reference I have used to prepare this presentation. Thanks for your attention, and this is very briefly how the kNN algorithm works.